And we start with that unfortunate jobs news now, because 30 of the 100 people who work at the big peanut plant in Portales are now looking for new jobs. Sunland Inc. laid them off yesterday after the Food and Drug Administration suspended the plant's registration earlier this week, basically shutting the plant down for now. Sunland's peanut butter got contaminated with salmonella earlier this fall. You probably remember this big story. It made more than 40 people sick all across the country.
Sunland is doing everything that it possibly can to reopen the shelling facilities, and then when the peanut butter plant is ready to go, then go back into full production. We do realize the impact that the plant has on the community.
The plant says it has done everything the FDA has ordered to decontaminate things and is now working with the federal government to try to get the plant up and running once again. And we now know why 5 security workers at the Los Alamos National Lab got fired last week. The Los Alamos Monitor says the group let people who were not supposed to go to the shooting range there and let people go ahead and use a number of different types of guns. The lab has not said who the security workers are.
This morning, the doors to the Albuquerque Hostess outlet store on Osuna are officially closed for good. Management said it had no choice but to shut it down since Hostess declared bankruptcy earlier this month. Customers bought up the last of the goodies yesterday, just before the doors closed. But not all is lost. Hostess Brands says it is in talk with about 110 potential buyers for the product lines it makes, including Twinkies, Ding Dongs, and Ho-Hos. The bankruptcy led to more than 18,000 layoffs nationwide. Locally, about 24 people lost their jobs.
All right, let's get some better business news now. Lots of stores in Nob Hill are probably going to get a big boost this weekend thanks to the Twinkle Light Parade and the Holiday Shop and Stroll. For the very first time, they're happening together and in Nob Hill. So starting tomorrow at noon, Central Avenue is going to be blocked off to all the cars. A lot of stores will have some big sales all day long, and they hope that you go check them out and shop local.
We get a lot of nice new customers for Shop and Stroll. It's a great exposure to the Nob Hill area. It's a great walking environment for the businesses.
And when you get tired of shopping, get a bite to eat, relax, and watch a Twinkle Light Parade. Instead of going down Central through the western part of the city, it's going to go through Nob Hill, and that starts at 5:15.
A Roswell man is murdered in a storm of gunfire, and sadly, kids are caught in the chaos. Now police are trying to put all the pieces together. The victim has been identified as 22-year-old Arthur Contreras. Witnesses say they heard up to 25 shots in all. They also say the children were outside when the killing happened.
If there is a shooter on the loose, you know, should neighbors, witnesses, the public be concerned? Are they in immediate danger?
The police department does not believe that this was a random act of violence at this time.
Now, police aren't saying if any arrests have been made. This is the 7th murder so far this year in Chavez County.
Well, the man from Belen who is accused of threatening Governor Susana Martinez is set to be in court in just a few hours. James Sanchez is supposed to plead guilty or not guilty this morning. He is charged with misdemeanor telephone harassment. It's after investigators say he left voicemails threatening the governor and her staff, even telling her to sleep with one eye open. Investigators say Sanchez was upset because he didn't think the state was doing enough to get rid of cows that were roaming near his home. After he got out of jail earlier this month, Sanchez went to the Veterans Hospital in Albuquerque to get help with post-traumatic stress disorder.
An Albuquerque family packs up and moves out of their home, leaving their two dogs to fend for themselves. Animal advocates say they're seeing this all too often, and the problem is increasing. One of the abandoned dogs, Zara, is a brand new mother of 6 puppies. Would you take a look at this? She's now at the Animal Humane Shelter in Albuquerque. She was lucky to have been found in time, they tell us. In another case, 2 dead dogs were found in a Santa Fe home after they spent weeks without food or water. Their owners had simply moved away without them.
Some people feel guilt taking the animal into a shelter, and they don't want to have to deal with it. They assume that someone will step up and take the animals in.
Now, regarding Zara and her puppies, they will be ready for adoption in just a couple of weeks. Authorities are searching for her owners, who could now face charges. Today, Northwestern Mutual is hosting a dedication event at UNM Children's Hospital. The dedication is to kick off Northwestern's Childhood Cancer Support Program, which will provide support to kids and their families facing childhood cancer. It starts at 2:30 this afternoon on the 6th floor of UNM's Children's Hospital. Well, in the spirit of giving, the Toys for Tots campaign is still going on, but there are some deadlines associated with it that we want to pass along to you.
Yeah, you have just a few more weeks to go pick up toys and donate them to families in need. And even more pressing, you have just a few more days to sign up if you want to get toys for your family from the Marines. News 13's David Romero is here this morning with everything you need to know. David, we are really getting close to the holidays.
It's getting close, Matt, and there are two big things we need to pass along this morning. Of course, collection boxes like this one here that we have at the station. There are dozens of them around town. They still need to be filled. And, of course, the deadline for families to get registered to receive those gifts is coming up, and that's approaching next week, and that's Monday and Tuesday. Now, organizers say they have had moderate success so far with this year's collection, but they still need more toys to come in to accommodate all the families that they anticipate will be signing up for the gifts. Now, at this point, they have about 2,500 families registered with about 1 to 3 kids each. With what they have collected so far, they may only be able to accommodate half of that, or 30.
So what I'd like to ask is for everybody to kind of dig deep this year, reach in their pockets, go to the toy stores, bring some toys to us, and then volunteer to be part of the distribution as well so that we can be successful.
And again, the most important thing they want to stress is that these boxes need to be filled with nice toys that are unwrapped and, of course, brand new for those families so they can have a nice Christmas holiday for the kids. That happens until December 10th to drop off those toys at the collection boxes. And, of course, there will be a call center where they will take monetary donations. That will be at the Albuquerque Police Department on next Thursday, and that is sponsored by KRQE. Matt, back to you.
All right, thank you, David. It's a great time to get in the spirit and help some folks out. Don't forget the big toy drive, as David mentioned, is going to be on Monday, December 10th. It's at the American Home Furnishings parking lot. It's at Carlisle and Manal. You can drop toys and cash off there all day long. You can find more information about this on our website, krqe.com. Click on news links.